evil one's name. Take thee light and burn thee bright, and the spell be cast aright.
A spell of witchcraft. With Patricia Crowther. This week, the old religion.
I wouldn't recognise one of those things.
Well, as long as they don't hurt anybody else, it doesn't matter, I don't think.
I should think they have to be an unhappy sort of person to take up witchcraft.
Well, I think they're all a make-up. I don't think there's any real truth about them.
Oh, no, definitely not. It's just like fantasy, isn't it?
No chance. No, no. No chance a witch is being about.
Is to have a little cross in your pocket, made of Wickham wood. Wickham is a country name for the rowan or the mountain ash. And of course, the mountain ash is the best specific you can have against witchcraft.
I married one.
I know.
You married a witch?
Something like that. Well, I think the shellfish all are very rubbish.
I lent them in with my phrase nutters. Them? Nutters.
Well, if you believe what you hear and what you read, it could be harmful, couldn't it?
What do you imagine they do?
Cast spells.
Evil practices.
Make sacrifices.
I've no idea.
Only smashing graves up and things like that. That's what I don't.
I think it's all bunkum. Absolute bunkum.
Talk first about what witchcraft isn't. It's not the evil thing that popular newspapers like to make out. It's got nothing to do with Satanism and black magic. We don't go about opening graves and holding black masses. And you can forget about witches with crooked noses and hunched backs riding for the night on broomsticks. Joan of Arc wasn't like that, but she was a witch. So was Robin Hood, with his coven of 13 people. William the Conqueror was born of a witch. And Robert Burns knew a lot about witchcraft. The witchcraft has nothing to do with the eerie picture that most people have in their minds. This is how someone who isn't a witch describes the cult.
I know it is one of the oldest religions in the world and has been very much maligned during history, chiefly by Christianity and by the Christian Church, because they regarded it all usually as a serious rival. Also, like any other religion, it has been corrupted.
A religion much maligned, and I hope to redress some of the balance in this series on witchcraft. You'll be able to hear the voices of a lot of people who are witches now, and also hear from people who have benefited from the craft. I'll be carrying out a witchcraft ritual, and we'll also go back and trace the history of this very old religion. Witch. The name is derived from the Anglo-Saxon word wicca, which means wise. Witchcraft simply means the craft of the wise people. Nothing sensational or horrific in that. Ours is the oldest religion in Western Europe, and it's being revived again by ordinary people. People like you and me, all over the country and here in Sheffield. Witchcraft is among us now.
I've always believed in a supreme being, but I can never think of the supreme being as being entirely male. I've always thought there was duality, a father god and a mother goddess.
Is it then the feminine side of witchcraft that interests you as a religion?
Yes.
Why?
I suppose really because I'm a woman, and I always feel that a mother goddess is in charge of these islands, and I wanted something personal, and something personal to England, as I am English.
How did you really find out about witchcraft?
Well, I studied for the many religions, and it seemed a natural thing to me, and I was always trying to find another goddess, and I realised that, well, since time began, there's always been a mother, and a mother goddess aspect, and a female aspect of the deity.
Well, what kind of a religion is it? We worship two deities, the god of hunting and death, and a goddess of fertility and rebirth. The god of the witches is a horned god. Why the horns? Because prehistoric man, before he had weapons, had to stampede cattle over the cliffs to kill them. To do this, a man dressed in an animal skin and wearing a headdress of horns would rush among the beasts. It took a brave man to do this, and no doubt he was looked upon as a hero. Man bases his gods on what he sees and knows, and fashioned his god on the greatest man in the tribe. This was the man with the horns, who enabled them to eat and live. In this way, the horned god was born. What happens to an old religion when a new one comes along? Very often the old beliefs are made out to be evil. The old gods are turned into devils and demons. And this is what happened to witchcraft. The horned god, known affectionately as Old Horny, was given hoofs and turned into the devil himself, or Old Nick. Has derived through Christianity from Old Nick, and he's not half so frightening. For the god who was Old Nick was also Nicholas, Saint Nicholas, the patron saint of children. He's better known over here as Santa Claus, and he still has his horns, only now they're on his reindeer, and in Cornwall he wears them on his head. So when you sent those letters up the chimney to Father Christmas, really you were writing to the god of the witches. So the church turned the horned god into the devil. But it forgot about the mother goddess. She's been worshipped from the beginning of time under many names. Diana, Isis, Artemis, Aphrodite. But she was forgotten even in the witch trials. And it seems the church couldn't think of an evil character to turn her into. We symbolize the goddess as the moon. But in one of her guises, you can see her every time you take a penny out of your pocket. The goddess was canonized by the church as Saint Bridget. But in Britain, her oldest names were Anne or Annis and Bride. From there, it's only a short step to Brit Annis or Brit Anya, the feminine force behind all nature, goddess of the moon, the sacred fire, and also of the sea.
Thank you.
Spaniards, we know her on our pennies and pound notes. Like them, I suppose it's fair to say that she's been devalued from being the goddess of these islands. On a pound note, she has an ear of corn in her hand. This denotes her as the mother of agriculture. The cross on her shield, though it's been made into a Union Jack on the penny, is a symbol of life, like the ancient Egyptian ankh, or cross, which was a pagan symbol thousands of years before Christianity. The shape of the shield represents the womb of the Great Mother herself, and the trident, as well as being a phallic symbol of fertility, shows her rulership over the sea. The lighthouse that you see on your penny denotes that she rules over the fire as the guardian of the home. So Britain, the mother country, is ruled by the mother goddess. Three Christian witches sang this as they danced round the fields using a pole as a hobby horse. By the way, they never flew on broomsticks. That's an old wives' tale. But they may have used broomsticks as they used poles in a fertility rite to make crops grow. The pole, of course, was a phallic symbol, and this was a form of sympathetic magic, a prayer combined with action. The crops were expected to grow as high as the dancers leapt in the air, going round and round, faster and faster, faster and faster.
The higher we jump, the higher they grow, around and around and around we go. The higher we jump, the higher they grow, around and around and around we go. The higher we jump, the higher they grow, around and around and around we go.
Witches didn't really fly. Maybe the idea of them flying came from people seeing them dancing and saying afterwards, I saw the witches flying round the fields on their broomsticks. Our religion is full of ritual and symbolism. We hold our rites in a circle. This represents the womb of the Great Mother, and is also the borderland between this world and the domain of the gods. And the cauldron, again a feminine symbol, the womb of nature. And of course, there's a practical use for the cauldron. In olden times, the village witch was marriage counsellor, midwife, herbalist, hypnotist, and psychologist. And she mixed her herbs and worked her cures in the cauldron. The word pharmacy is derived from the ancient Greek pharmakia. This word didn't just mean the compounding of drugs, it also meant witchcraft. And the word pharmacon, besides meaning a drug, also meant an enchanted potion, a philtre, or a love charm. And so the white-coated chemist has his origins back through the centuries in the witches who cull their herbs according to the phases of the moon.
At one stage, I was taken to the X-ray department, an X-ray, to find the position of blockages in the digestive system, stones in the ducts from the liver, which don't go away on their own. The picture was duly taken, and the attendant took it into the adjacent room for the surgeon to study. Presently she came back. He doesn't believe it, she said. I have to take another. So another lengthy session of X-ray, and still there was nothing there. The magic had worked. There was no need for a further operation.
Yes. Witches still work magic, and in a later programme you'll hear people like this lady from Chesterfield testifying to it. But if you ask a witch, what is magic? She'll say she doesn't know, but it works. The witch's ways of raising power have been handed down by word of mouth through the centuries, and we who are carrying on the craft want to use it for the good. We're not setting out to harm anyone.
Well, I was brought up in the Christian religion and never really got anything out of it at all. It didn't mean anything to me. I prayed to this God, and nothing ever happened. Then I sort of rejected this God and didn't go looking for anything else, and witchcraft found me.
We do not do anything that is evil. It is just a common belief, and we work for the good of the people and the community as a whole.
I've finally found an anchor.
We do it worshipping like most people do. But where most people worship God, we worship the God and goddess of fertility. And without fertility, nothing grows or nothing stems. You're working for the good of nature.
It's changed my whole life. It makes me very happy. It makes me feel entirely secure. It's given me a sense of power, really, in myself, under the guidance of Mother Goddess.
I wanted a religion that I could believe in without, you know, having to sort of question it. Christianity, for instance, there's so many loopholes that you can question. And witchcraft is such a simple religion. It's the religion of our land.
I don't think it's narrow, because I think the Mother Goddess gives you a vision to see a very much greater perspective.
I think that God, that we were brought up to believe in, is too far away to reach. And the goddess, as I say, is the goddess of these lands, and she's much closer to us.
I'm aware of her, well, of her love and her compassion.
I didn't know who I was praying to. I laid in bed at night thinking, I wish this would happen and the other would happen. And eventually, things did start to happen. And then I met Pat and was introduced to witchcraft. And I think this was the goddess calling. I really do think that.
Wisdom. Wise. Wicca. Witch. A religion. A very ancient and real one. A way of life that no one need be ashamed of following. Those who do follow it regard everything connected with it as sacred and precious. The wise craft, a religion that extends from the darkness of Britain's most ancient history to the darkness just outside your door. No need to be afraid of witchcraft.